Hi, my name is Old Dude. Still trying to practice my liquid here. And this tutorial, feel kind of weird even saying tutorial because you say, well, you're a beginner, what do you have to teach? Well, this is just my video diary charting my progress with liquid, and hopefully it can help other beginners who are on the same liquid journey that I'm on. If you don't like it, that's okay. You can turn to something else, something better. There's a lot better stuff, but maybe this would be some help to someone, and at any rate, I'm going to do it anyway, so you might as well listen in. You might find something that you like. When I started doing liquid, once I started learning the basic hand flows that everybody is, you know, taught, you know, the boxes, the flower movements, the tunnels, and I know I don't do them perfectly, you know, but once I learned these kind of basic movements, I found myself in a position saying, okay, now that I kind of have somewhere to go, you know, with these movements, man, what do I do? Because I kind of find that I'm just repeating movements and it looks kind of, you know, boring, kind of, you know, simple, you know. So I found out with liquid, once you kind of know the basic movements, basic principles, what you have to do is go out and find these other movements and create on your own. And so that's what I started doing. One thing that I was fascinated with while watching one of these undersea nature shows was weeds or seaweed, the way it would move in the water. It kind of looked like this, kind of like it was blowing in the wind, only there was no wind. There was, you know, just water, you know, kind of moving it. And I became fascinated, you know, with that movement and said, hey, maybe I can, you know, incorporate that, you know, into my liquid. There is water involved. And the way that I taught myself how to do that, it's two ways. The first way was just shaking my hands like this, just really kind of shaking. This was an exercise I remember when I was doing Tai Chi for my therapy. We would just shake our hands like this, you know, and I started playing with the movement, just shaking it just a little slower, like this, slowing it down, until I pretty much got it like this. Great workout for your muscles also. And then I started moving it forward, moving it backward, moving it diagonally across like I'm flying, you know, trying to move it in the circle, just really moving it up, moving it down, you know, trying to combine it, you know, with the liquid hand flow kind of motion. And it seemed to work, you know, so this is one way to kind of get it. You just kind of shake your hand like this. Yeah, freaky that looks. You just kind of shake your hand like this and then just gradually slow it down. You know, you can, what great thing about this movement is you can slow it down, you can speed it up, you know, depending on what kind of wind you have, you know. The left hand, since it's like the non-dominant hand, it moves a little weirder, you know, than the right hand. When you combine it like this here, you know, it can really kind of look freaky. You come here, 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 you know, so it really looks kind of strange. You don't want to do that too much, or people will kind of figure out what you're doing and say, oh, he's not really doing anything. But, you know, if you're doing, I suppose, if you're doing something like this and you just kind of just throw it in, you know, just throw that in there and then just, you know, go on to something else, you know, you'll disguise it. So that's one thing that I did. Another thing, you know, was just, you know, working this out, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Just working the fingers every day. Because I noticed that in order to do a lot of flowing movements, you can't have tight fingers. So I just got in the habit of doing this as fast as I could, you know, and once I kind of got this down, I started experimenting doing this. You know, I know this is a standard digits move, you know, I don't do it very good. you know, but, you know, I do it enough, I do it well enough, you know, that I'm actually satisfied with it, you know, and it, all it is just putting your fingers back and forth like this here, and really stretching them out. This, believe it or not, this takes a long time to do, at least it took me a long time to do, you know, so that's another thing, another exercise. Another one that I did was here, 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 all right? Just doing that every day, every free moment that I got. That along with 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. You know, and then just kind of combining it to get this kind of weird kind of effect, you know. It helps also to visualize that you're trying to grab something that's just out of reach, just out of reach, just out of reach, just out of reach, just out of reach. The last kind of exercise that I did, you know, it's kind of like a hand washing. Come here, 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 here. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. You know, and then you just kind of, all I'm doing is washing, is, you know, it's just the basic hand washing movement. You know, you're washing your hands like this, you know, at the, I started to say at the toilet, I don't wash my hands at the toilet. You know, if you start washing your hands at the sink, it's basically doing like this, you know, and then just really overemphasizing doing that, you know. I kind of call it sloppy digits until I get better at doing digits, but, you know, got to start somewhere. You know, if you kind of suck, you know, you got to start somewhere until you kind of get more refined. But, you know, maybe this is something that can help you on your liquids journey. You know, it is certainly helping me. It's making the dance a lot more, you know, fun, you know, for me, you know, certainly. And hopefully this is something, you know, that will work for you. So until next time, it's old dude just doing that liquid.